Hey, SmartPak fans. Welcome to a special edition of Ask the Vet. You may notice I'm sitting on this side, not that side. I'm Dr. Lydia Gray, the Staff Veterinarian and Medical Director at SmartPak. This is Nerida Richards, PhD. I'm going to let you introduce yourself.
Sure. Thanks, Lydia. So I'm Nerida. I'm an equine nutritionist from Australia, which is probably quite obvious given my accent.
I was going to say far.
Yeah.
Obvious. True.
I work as a consulting nutritionist in Australia. I formulate feeds and supplements for companies all over the world. And I also run the feedxl.com website, which is a nutrition calculator that horse owners use to put their horses' diets together.
We love it. Yeah. Great. We ask you to submit your horse nutrition questions specifically, and then this segment will answer one of those questions. You'll answer one of those questions. Mm-hmm. I'm helping. And then to see the other questions, just click on the playlist at the end of the video, and you get to see them all. So, ready?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Ready.
Can you touch base about grass and legume type hays? What are the benefits to the horse and their overall in terms of overall health? Mm-hmm. Is a certain mixture better or preferred for certain horses, like the A-list pasture pet, light work, moderate to heavy work, hard keeper, easy keeper, etc. Mm-hmm. And then she has some examples of different types of hays. Bird's foot trefoil, mm-hmm. orchard grass, Timothy, Kentucky bluegrass, brome, and then one that I'm not familiar with, so I'm hoping you'll speak to it, spring green fasciolaleum.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm not familiar with that one either, but a grass species, as far as I know, but I'm not going to talk about that one because
okay.
I don't know it. But I think one of the fundamentally most important things when you're putting a diet together for a horse is to get a lot of variety in the diet.
Okay.
So, you know, I could sit and formulate on paper a perfectly balanced diet out of oats, Timothy hay and a supplement, and it would look like it's meeting all of the requirements.
It checks all the boxes.
It does, but they're only the boxes that we know about.
Oh.
So when we're looking at, say, amino acids, generally all we look at is lysine because mm-hmm. it's the only one mm-hmm. that we have an established requirement for.
That's right.
And our thinking is that if we meet lysine requirement, then all the other amino acids that are essential in the diet will be met. But they may not be with a really limited number of ingredients.
Mm-hmm.
So there's all these nutrients that I call secondary nutrients.
Okay.
So they're essential, and even chlorophyll is one, the green stuff in grass and hay.
Right.
So we know they're needed in some amount. We just don't know how much, and a lot of the times we don't even really know where they come from. So you, by putting together a whole variety of grasses and legumes and the trefoil, you've got much better chance of meeting all of those secondary nutrients,
yeah,
as well as all the primary nutrients that we know about when you feed it with a balance of pellet or a supplement. So ingredient variety is really, really important. And then as far as the mixes go, there's generally optimum mixes for different horses.
So like she described, the pasture pet, the light work, the heavy work.
So for a pasture pet that's really not doing very much and they're mature, I mean, their protein requirements are quite low, their calorie requirements are low. So a mature grassy hay, maybe with just a really small component of legume, so an alfalfa mm-hmm. or a clover,
mm-hmm.
Just to bring in the nutrient that they are rich in, so amino acids and calcium that they'll bring in. But you want to try and keep the calorie and the protein content reasonably low because otherwise they...
Because the horse isn't exercising.
They don't need very much.
Yeah.
But then if you're looking at a weanling thoroughbred and you are having to feed them hay, I mean, their protein requirements are huge at that age and their calorie requirements are
mm-hmm.
really high.
Mm-hmm.
So you would start to use blends that have got more legume. You know, we use a lot of alfalfa for growing horses.
Right.
So, you know, the blend, the optimum blend changes because all of a sudden you're not worried about maintaining body condition or
mm-hmm.
keeping body condition off a mature horse. You're more concerned with, are they getting enough calories to grow at the rate we need them to grow? Are they getting enough protein
right.
to build the muscle? So you're using a much higher quality, much more nutrient-dense blend of forages. And then your performance horses are going to be somewhere in between.
Mm-hmm.
So their calorie requirements
are higher.
Because they're
adults, so they're not growing, but they're exercising,
yes.
so their workload. Yeah,
yeah, and you want them, you know, to be maintaining or building muscle. So again, you know, some component. I'm a big fan of having both grass and legume in your hay blend. So whether
because
you
of the blend, the difference, the variety.
Just, yeah,
okay.
and all these nutrients that we don't really understand. And bringing in different proteins. You know, we just analysed some grasses even for amino acids. So just two different species of grass.
Mm-hmm.
And the amino acid content in them is dramatically different.
Hmm.
They're both grasses.
Right.
But the amino acid content is dramatically
okay.
different.
Yeah.
So just bringing in that variety good. Is really important. It's a good question.
All right. So if she's doing it this way, if she is using a blend, then she's doing it the right way.
Absolutely.
All right.
Yeah.